Now it's Ask the Dietitian with Sally Sawaya from Sally's Diet Right.
Sally has just spilled her coffee all over the floor.
But it was like the powdered version.
You have any more powder?
Yes.
Okay, good.
One spare.
So welcome Sally Sawaya from Sally's Diet Right. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So Olga's here and Sally is from Sally's Diet Right in Rabie. And what kind of things are you helping people with at the moment, Sally?
Weight loss, weight gain, sports-related nutrition consultations, gastric problems, if you have any problems with your digestive tract, pregnancy, diet, kids. Lots of kids are coming in because now they're regulating their food intake.
Yeah, now back to school. Exactly. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, so that's it.
At school, is the food healthy? The actual
unfortunately, it's not very healthy, Gavin. So that's why it's easier to get a healthy lunchbox from home rather than buy those things in the cafeterias at school.
What about those sit-down lunches? Sometimes they have like tabakh and stuff.
Yeah,
are those
okay? Okay, yes. As long as the food is not fried, it's fine. If it's tabakh or cooked food, yes, we do advise the children have these.
Now, you've come with your top five things, I presume.
It's something related to the fall, to autumn, to the season.
How did you know?
I read it on your paper.
It's some important nutrition facts about five autumn fruits.
Oh, okay. So these are things that are in season right now.
Exactly,
okay,
yes.
Cool. Okay, let's do it. The top five things with Sally Sawaya. And the five autumn fruits. Let me try and play that again.
Song
Sorry.
Decided to
just try and do it again. Just a second. There it is. Okay. So, what is it, number five?
Number five, it's grapes.
Grapes, okay.
We love grapes.
It's the season.
Exactly. And it has lots of vitamins and minerals, but the most beneficial ingredient in grapes are the, you know, antioxidants found in red or purple grapes.
Okay.
These are polyphenols like resveratrol. They are very heart protective. They are protective for body cells and very beneficial for heart health. Because, you know, the red wine is
it's made out of those grapes.
Yes, exactly.
So it's better to have the darker grapes and not the white ones?
The white ones contain some antioxidants, but the red or purple variety are richer in resveratrol, so more protective for the heart and against other diseases.
Okay.
But remember, 15 grapes is 60 calories.
Okay.
Only 15 grapes, 60 calories.
So like a little handful.
Yes.
Okay.
Wow. How about a mango? Because I was eating a mango yesterday and I thought,
off topic.
Half a small mango is 60 calories.
Oh, is that all?
Yes. So if you have a small mango, that's two servings of fruits, which is okay.
Okay, so back to your list.
The
autumn fruits, number four.
Figs.
Oh, okay.
Oh, God. Yes. Granny food.
Yes.
I'm not a big fan of figs, but I know a lot of people do love them.
They love them now, and lots of people gain weight because of figs.
Yeah.
Because only two figs are 60 calories.
And usually you eat more.
Yeah, you definitely eat more. But what's very nice about figs is that they are rich in soluble fiber. So this fiber helps lower your bad cholesterol.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also rich in prebiotics. These help support a healthy digestive system in the gut. So they are the food for the good bacteria in the gut.
Oh, okay, nice.
And that's why they improve your digestive wellness.
I saw someone recently was eating, apparently this is like a family secret, and they posted this on Instagram of how they eat figs. They dip it in za'atar. So you cut it in half, you dip it in za'atar, and then you eat the fig.
Oh, wow.
So it's like a really interesting combination of salt and sweet.
Mm,
yeah.
That sounds better. What's the difference between figs and dates, though? Are they
dates
different?
Dates are the small ones. Yes. Figs are the big green. Figs are these.
Dates like are, they grow in palm trees, Gavin. Those dates.
Mm.
This is a fig.
Oh, that's a fig.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Oh, I just remember my grandmother always eating figs.
But now it's the season, Gavin. You don't eat at all?
I've never eaten.
I'm not a big fan of this fruit particularly myself, but everyone loves it.
Yeah, everyone loves it.
Yeah, they are quite nice. It's the dried figs maybe I'm thinking of.
Maybe.
The dried figs are really healthy also.
Okay, autumn fruits number three.
Apples.
Yes.
Those green, juicy
They're
apples.
They're so great right now. They're perfectly juicy. I hate those soggy,
soggy
apples.
Ones.
Disgusting, dried up.
True. No, it's the season, and it's true. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. It's true because it's due mainly to the high fiber content of apples and also their antioxidants, polyphenols, especially quercetin. And this was shown to again improve heart health and prevent certain diseases such as cancer.
Okay.
And what's nice about apples is that they make you feel full because they're full of fiber.
I've heard that before. If you have an apple half an hour before your meal, it's supposed to make you eat less.
Exactly. So you eat less. In one study, it was shown you eat less during the meal.
Yeah.
Number two?
عناب.
Oh.
جوجوب. جوجوب.
I know عناب because we grow it in our village in Pembroke.
Oh yeah, I don't like those things.
Yeah.
They look like olives, they taste like apples.
Exactly. Everybody loves them.
Yeah.
I don't love them.
Except for Gavin.
Except for Gavin and Sally and me.
You don't like them either?
I don't like them too
really?
Much.
Really?
But people love them and they are low in calories, by the way. Half okay. a cup is like 60 calories. And it's called cheese, it's called Chinese red dates. So that's why not many people know the English version of
Anne. Oh, really? Okay.
And they're so rich in vitamin C. So only half a cup can satisfy your needs of vitamin C for the whole day.
That's good.
And, you know, vitamin C helps strengthen your body defenses.
Yeah.
So it's really healthy.
Good.
And number one of the autumn fruits.
Cactus fruit.
Oh, I love cactus. What's it called?
Prickly pear or sabir.
Sabir, exactly.
It's really healthy.
Have you had that, Gavin? It's all full of seeds.
I'm not sure.
Cactus well, I mean, it looks like a cactus on the outside, but then you have to peel off the thing very carefully. And inside, it's like lots and lots of little seeds like this.
Yeah, exactly. Mm.
They look
very
like this
rich in fiber. It's so it makes you feel so full. And it's very good for your digestion and prevention of constipation. So rich in fiber. Also, it has lots of vitamin C and magnesium. And magnesium is great for normal muscle and nerve function.
Yeah.
So here you go
so
for
it's good
cactus.
For you.
Yes, very good.
I love this fruit. I think it's really yummy.
Yeah, great.
Thank you.
Welcome.
If you have a question for Sally Sawyer from Sally's Diet Right, our WhatsApp number 03-887-000. What do you want to ask Sally Sawyer this morning?
Say, 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 hey, hey, now, baby. Oh, mama, don't play now, baby. Say, 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 hey, hey, now, baby. So let's go on things straight now, baby.
It's Maroon 5 featuring Cesar. It's What Lovers Do. It's Gavin Ford in the morning. Olga's here. And Sally Sawyer in the studio. You'd be impressed, by the way, Sally Sawyer. Went what? To a very nice dinner at Divi the other night.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a new light menu.
Yeah.
Which is really healthy. Have you seen it?
Yes.
You've experienced the new light menu?
I love this restaurant.
Really?
The starters are so good. They have like little dim sums and...
Oh, yum.
They're
so
really,
this is
really
like
good.
The new light stuff on the menu. Mm.
Yeah, they have this new light menu. There's like these little sandwiches, there's vegetable woks, there's mozzarella wraps, there's all
the
kinds of things.
The halloumi skewers are good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they are good.
I've tried these, yes.
Yeah. So thank you for a very nice night at Divi the other night, and thank you for showing off your very nice light menu.
Yeah.
And the light menu, actually, I prefer to the other menu, which isn't usual. It's not usual like that.
Yeah.
Usually, you go to a restaurant and you get given
you kind of ignore the light menu.
Yeah. I would never even look at the light menu usually, but this menu is amazing.
It's really good.
It's really tasty. So Sally Sawyer, Sally's Diet Right, and if you have a question, it's 03-887-000. What would you like to ask Sally Sawyer from Sally's Diet Right this morning? What have we got so far?
So actually somebody was saying we were talking about cactus fruit and they said, I thought cactus fruit is bad and causes constipation.
It's actually the other way around because it's rich in insoluble fiber, which actually is good to prevent.
So makes you go.
Yes, prevents constipation. But make sure if your diet is rich in fiber, so it's fruits and vegetables, whole grains and beans, make sure to drink lots of water.
Okay.
Because if you don't drink water, then you will have constipation. So you need to drink at least 2 liters a day just to make the food pass smoothly through your digestive system.
Somebody's asking how many, we've been talking about all these amazing fruits, how many fruits can we have per day? What's the serving?
It's normally 3 pieces or servings a day. Mm-hmm. I mean by 3, like one serving is like an apple, a small banana, an orange, but can mean also 15 pieces of grapes, 2 pieces of
or
figs,
like half a mango.
Yes, exactly. 2 to 3 plums or khoukh. So it differs with each type of fruit, but it's normally 3 pieces. Those who exercise a lot can have 4 pieces.
Sorry, what's khoukh? Yes.
Prunes.
Plums.
Oh, plums. Yes.
Say it again.
What's the Arabic name?
Khoukh.
Khoukh.
That's
horrible. How would they ever sell those things? And it's such a horrible sounding name. I'll have some khoukh, please. Sounds awful.
This person is saying, Sally, anything that helps with muscle soreness after a workout, any recommended supplements? Is there any food you can take for that?
No, but there's several studies that say if you have a cup of coffee before exercise, mm-hmm. it helps increase your performance and reduce soreness at the end of the workout.
Really?
But definitely you should ask your personal trainer, because there are other things that you can do, like exercise leisurely the second day and so on and so forth.
So it's more of a diet, more of a gym thing
exactly,
than a diet thing.
Exactly.
Okay. Someone's asking, I'm stopping the gym shortly. What do you recommend in order to gain weight?
Is that the same person who asked the question? No, because I heard Patrick on Monday, and someone will be stopping gym again.
Oh yeah, you're right. On Monday they did send a question.
Don't stop the gym.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there anything
So the question to Patrick was, I'm currently working out properly and consuming protein along with my training. I'm planning to stop gym for 2 months. How should my last 3 weeks of training be? And then today they were asking, I'm stopping the gym. What do you recommend in order to gain weight?
To gain weight.
I feel like there's a knot that's missing here.
Not gain weight. Yes, definitely it should be a knot. Because normally when you go to the gym, you are burning more calories. So most probably you'll have to reduce like 300 to 400 calories every day so that you don't gain weight. Mm-hmm. So again, make sure it depends. It's actually personalized. It's better to have a one-to-one chat about this so that we can reduce the calories moderately and not gain weight.
Okay. Someone's asking, a low-fat diet makes me shiver and feel cold more often. Is this right? Or is there something wrong?
What I know is when you lose weight and you lose fat, you start getting colder because
fat
is an insulator. Yes, exactly.
That's why you eat more in the winter, because your body's like preparing for the cold.
Yeah, true. You have more fat, more sugar. You crave more of these
exactly.
to keep warm. But when you lose... I'm not sure about the type of diet and how it makes you feel cold, but definitely if you lose weight, you will feel colder.
Okay. Somebody's asking if a detox diet is good. Maybe there's different kinds of detox diets.
Yes, it depends on the diet. Now, Olga, bear with me. If you're having a lot of food for a whole week and you have weddings and dinners and you do 2 to 3 days of detox while juicing your fruits and vegetables, 2 to 3 days maximum, it's okay.
Okay.
But if you do the detox for longer than 3 days, then you start having, you're tired, you lose a lot of muscle mass, you know, so it's not advisable. But if your detox is for a week and you eat like vegetable foods, like legumes, fruits, vegetables, and, most of your diet will be based on vegetables for a week,
not
again,
juice.
It's okay.
It's just healthy foods, but not juice necessarily.
Yes, because if you go on juicing only vegetables and fruits, you are missing out on a lot of protein. Mm-hmm. But if you incorporate legumes like beans, lentils, zaadas, edamame, soybeans, things that contain a good amount of protein, then you'll be fine. Mm-hmm. But go for a balanced diet, the one we recommend.
Well, thank you very much for all your advice today.
You're welcome.
Thanks,
Gavin.
Sally.
Welcome.
Sally Sawaya is from Sally's Diet Right. How do we get in contact with you?
My Facebook page, Sally's Diet Right, and the right is spelled R-I-T-E, or my Insta.
And your Insta's what?
Again, Sally's Diet Right.
With the right spelled R-I-T-E. Sally, thank you.
Thank you.